terrible.
I love how I will give you pretty much any information you want, but the fact that you never asked for it just makes me giggle inside.
That is kind of
why funny. Did I take legend lore?
Right, have, so they're gonna probably go past the door.
Sense magic. No one has like sense magic, so we can sense the relic.
She didn't even tell you, like, well, you're about to go into a very powerful sorcerer family's home and
that
you're
going
to detect magic.
Glow like fucking Christmas.
Wait, no one has detect magic?
No, we do, but it probably wouldn't help that much.
I have to spell magic.
Alright, well, you and I
were on. You didn't even ask her what lock to use the stone on.
You didn't even ask her what this thing looked like. You guys are brilliant.
What were you guys doing? We were excited to be rolling. What were you guys doing?
I was rolling with you.
Their cousin.
You guys are definitely.
I'm busy being in the other place.
So I was banging their cousin,
lava.
So.
A lava true sight gem.
Because I have locate object.
Oh, yeah!
What? Finally someone has a useful spell!
What's the ring?
Okay, about? So let's see.
Do you have
it has to be,
is that one of your preferred spells?
Yes.
Okay.
It has to be an object that is familiar to me though.
Oh,
so that's what I'm wondering if it's been described. Describe or name an object that is familiar to you.
Make a wisdom check to ask Smalls what the fuck this is.
Oh my god, that's such a good way to do this.
I give her advantage.
Bardic inspiration.
Yeah, I have bardic inspiration.
Roll that. I thought you had an 8 now.
Yeah,
it's an 8,
now.
Yeah. Roll that.
That does not help. Wait, is it a saving throw or no?
No, it's just your
just a check. So, you're going to ask. You're basically asking Smalls, and this is going to be...
Would it be a history check, though? Or
I mean...
Probably in her. You have nothing helpful.
No.
Can I give her advantage on the thing?
What did you roll? How bad... Oh.
Yeah.
It's small, so I'm gonna say you're gonna roll.
Should
an
we go
advantage.
Back and ask Blinks, and then come back tomorrow night?
Actually, no,
let's roll back and forth a couple times.
Let's do this.
I imagine we move pretty quickly when we roll. Like, we're back again tonight.
I was about to do your high-low thing. Mm-hmm. Guess what? I just rolled on percentiles.
001.
50.
50. Are you serious? So technically, you're right either way. So.
Fuck my day. Do another roll this time. Do a history check for Smalls. I'm gonna say that Smalls has a very high wisdom and intelligence.
I don't have any stats for Smalls right now.
He is gonna have no stats except for his attack, but his wisdom and intelligence are both gonna be 20, so that would be +5 to your roll.
So that would be 20.
Rock on. Smalls is going to whisper to you. As everybody's kind of bickering, trying to figure out, they realize that they didn't ask her what to do. They're about to go have to, like, walk all the way back through town. It's like,
no, we're going to have to roll back.
They're going to roll back because that's a thing now.
I don't have a napkin covered in while I'm rolling yet.
And,
when they screw
Conte.
Up rolling, it'd be great.
Conte.
Autobots?
10.
Oh.
Ooh.
That's fun.
Oh, dear.
Oh, don't worry. I can't roll, so 4 fire damage. That's cute. That was 2d6. That's cute. That's real cute.
It's 69.
Giggity.
So accurate, though. Oh my god, that's amazing.
Wait, is he taking fire damage?
Is that what
too?
He said just now?
We're both doing fire back and forth. Oh yeah, because he's immune.
Da, 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 da. So let's talk more about our sponsor today of Skittles.
Skittles, also
and Qdoba.
And Qdoba.
And Pepsi.
And Pepsi.
Qdoba makes you.
There's like this picture. It's like, what do you want for your final meal? It's like someone's like
Skittles.
Chicken nuggets and he's like, Pepsi, okay.
Why did you stop me? Why did you wait that long to stop me?
Wait,
what?
What just happened?
Jerk.
Hey.
I love her, but she's a jerk.
What just happened with Smalls? What did Smalls do?
Well, I was trying to tell her what Smalls was saying and doing, but I was apparently whispering into her fucking deaf ear. Which she let me do for like 3 sentences.
She's like, it just feels good.
It's like, oh, I thought you were just doing this for fun. Sorry.
looking for.
Yeah, we're drinking Pepsi out of Coke glass, man. Everything's heresy right now.
I see, this is so wrong.
Fuck your rules,
Will. Dogs.
Your rules. I keep swearing, and I don't know if that's okay in your house. I feel bad about it.
Doesn't matter.
She's been swearing this entire time.
Hey,
I'm a
guest here.
A few times, and I'm like, oh, shit, I probably shouldn't be doing that. And then all of a sudden, you're just like, you see fucking spider, you gotta fucking kill it. And I'm like, oh, it's fine then.
Because I'm the guest. There's separate rules for
that's
guests.
Right, you are the guest in this house.
So I hope you enjoy yourself.
I feel like I should go. Wait, I don't know anymore. Should I stay?
So it'd be like, you're the fucking guest. Fuck you. And enjoy yourself.
Be goddamn polite.
So how's that Steam library growing there?
Stop browsing your computer.
I'm just waiting for him to actually start browsing porn and forget about it.
Hey, do it. Do it. Give us some entertainment.
Don't actually do it.
He starts playing a Serbian film in the background.
Hey.
Oh, God. No.
Oh, that was is that that terrible?
We don't have anything against like, Serbians, guys.
That's like if Albanians had a racial trait.
Once again.
They, like, launch cruise missiles at houses and stuff. It's not cool.
Like, what?
Nothing vicious being racist against Serbians, whatever.
Oh, that's totally fine.
It's just normal.
I'm nowhere near Serbia.
He's on the Russian sites. He's nowhere near Serbia.
You know, Russia until like 2 years ago considered like liquor like a soft drink.
Yes, I knew that.
Yeah, like 30% of their male population dies before like a certain age, straight due to liquor, like alcoholism and stuff like that.
Jeez.
See, normally this is where I would say, well, yeah, but there's nothing else for them to do. But you can rent a fucking tank. In Russia. I was like, you know,
yeah.
I'm gonna rent a tank. Just fuck it, it's Russia.
Well, yeah, but like after doing that all the time, like you'd be bored of that. It's only cool because you don't need to do that.
I just imagine me in like a full commander's office. I'm tired on top of my tank.
I'm so bored.
I need something new. I'm gonna go steal another type of. Then you do fighter jets. Oh, this is boring too. Passed out a few
guess
times.
Guess I will drink myself into death.
As per tradition, by the way. Yeah,
that's why the whole thing with Ukraine happened. Sergey, what do we do today?
I don't know.
To
let's
take
just...
over Ukraine.
Pinky
and Sergey.
Guys.
Yes, Chris.
Did you know you got to put this on YouTube, right?
We can
editing.
Add that.
Everything said today here was an act of fiction, either verbally or written down.
Fuck that. That's all going in.
Could I have a little
bit of
this?
Go right ahead.
This is what's
small.
If you want, we have glasses over
there
if you don't
want to
mix with whatever was in there.
Yeah,
I will say, if we
bash
Russia a few more times, I'm sure Reddit.
Yeah, I brought enough glasses out for one
just
in case people wanted
something. I also just like having a straw and a lid.
Because only if you want your smalls, it is up to you to how you relay that information and how you go about it. Because no one else can hear smalls, only you can.
Who's wearing that shirt? This guy at work. His name's Chris. He had a shirt that said, "You're killing me here, Smalls."
I just love the fact that the store is named Smalls.
That is
stop playing that.
I keep hearing that echo.
That's Will being a douche and squeezing the pop bottle.
What do
he's
you mean
pretending
echo?
Pretending it is.
Oh, like I hear myself.
Oh.
As he goes,
yeah,
she, yeah, it's Skype, internet.
It's Skype, mostly Skype.
Yeah, Skype is what does that.
You need to find a better one.
Skype went to shit after Microsoft bought it.
That is true. So true.
As for many things. There's Doritos over here.
Skype is like Disney.
Ghost using your chips.
Microsoft's like Disney.
That's a giant minefield of cords and computers
and
that go past.
Or just crawl under the table.
Don't.
Oh, yeah, you can go
that
way.
That's a clear path. Here,
yeah.
Hold on. Limbo under that
well,
table.
Well, it was a clear path.
Limbo, hold on. Did
what?
They fall over?
Nope.
No, I'm just...
You're good.
My leg.
I
need that.
No, you didn't.
While you were in the bathroom, I was going to run upstairs to get a bag of chips.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
I was just going to crawl into the table, but then you don't need any of
that. You do.
Harassment.
Harassment.
Yeah, because you're getting pretty frisky for a paladin.
It's lawful. Who cares, right?
What?
Okay.
That's dog.
Just having sex.
No. I mean, 14 no's and a yes
wait,
means yes.
Oh gosh.
It's fine.
That's it.
The magic.
Holy shit, that was quick.
I was just running upstairs.
She rolled. She judo rolled.
I did. I judo rolled up the stairs. Alright, catch.
Oh, got
how's
it.
That looking on the camera over there? Protect the nuts.
Well, on the camera, they just got a really good shot of my ass. And they also can see everything behind my screen.
Wait, I think this is too far.
That
for
you guys?
That's too far.
It's like you're practically putting the table on
my
top
leg.
Of them.
Yeah.
Stop poking your leg around the thing.
Stop poking the thing around my leg.
My leg.
I am probably.
My leg.
No, for real though, I did hurt my leg. I don't know what's wrong with it. I think I had tendonitis in it. Really sucked. I was hobbling around work like a gimp all day today.
I was having such a bad day.
You understand? I spent 10 hours. It was just bad.
Remember,
so was that on top of the car problem?
That was on top of the car problem. Everything's just going haywire. My manager's like ready to fire everybody except me.
You say cop problem? Like, what are you going to do now?
Well,
the
bro.
Cop problem.
What
I'm not sure if you know about this. Wait, what?
I didn't say that. There's never a problem with that.
Tell your weird old coworker to stop sending you weird Snapchats.
I'm just waiting for the titty one. I'm just waiting for that.
They're getting weirder and further away from titties every time she sends you one.
No, the weirdest one. Okay,
the body to the toe, underneath the toenail.
The weirdest one she sent me was her. She was in a bikini, in her backyard, rolling around the grass. And there was a fucking gravestone in her backyard saying, just spending time with dad. And I'm like, okay, what?
She sent some really weird Snapchats.
Family's important.
Apparently, like, he's buried in a graveyard somewhere, and...
Which is also their backyard with all their friends.
Yeah.
Apparently. And this is little Timmy's down the street. This is his gravestone rolling around on the grass.
All right, everyone, like, get on your bikinis and swimsuits.
They haven't found him yet.
Let's,
Are you doing the small today?
Yeah, let's stop giving me nightmares, because that's what's going to happen.
All
right. Creepy pasta one.
If Will's weird coworker is watching this, I'm sorry I called you weird.
I'm not. You're fucking weird.
Fun times.
I do appreciate a good roll around in the grass, though.
But,
she is cute.
Oh, in that case, wait.
No,
she's weird, though.
Because then the creepy kind of turns to cute, too.
Is it like the hot crazy scale, but hot creepy scale?
Is it like the exponential graph or whatever?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where it just drops
a little bit of it's kind of balancing out.
Wait, that means she's perfectly willing to do in a graveyard.
That's weird.
I don't want no
even, you know, I'm, yeah.
Anyway, we're going to get back to where we is as you guys are figuring out what's going down. What's going down?
I see her, like, muttering to herself. What's going on over there?
Do you have any magical skills? Do you have, like, sense magic or find items or something?
My sword knows where it is.
Your sword knows?
Yes.
Sword.
So you have a sword that's a nose, or is it your sword?
Bro, why did I have the mask, though?
My sword does have a face.
What the?
With a nose.
What's he doing? Is that a clown mask?
Okay.
Nope.
Yeah. Well,
like, why?
Nope.
That's terrifying.
Back of the manor, third floor. To open a window, go past a few doors to a spiral staircase, to a magical vault in the attic.
Wow, this sword knows a lot.
The Firestone key has to be used to open the vault.
It's very
specific. So you have to break into the house some other way.
I wonder if he's going to change masks, like, just keep changing masks.
So,
if you need to get up to the window, I can get up to a window.
Okay,
easily.
Okay.
What
I'm not
sure if those near you. The Firestone key has to be saved for the vault, so I don't think we can use it to open up anything else.
I'm not proficient in lockpicking. Nor do I have
He opened the front door just by blasting fire at it. Someone just, like, throw a fireball at the front door. Someone just do this.
I don't know
it's
if
easy,
you've ever
right?
seen a fireball or heard a fireball.
He has a sword that flame shoots fire. He has a fire-breathing potion. Somebody just shoot the damn
it's
door with fire.
Are we just going to walk into this place?
What did I call it? What did I say?
You can't just walk in.
I'm going to look. Okay,
you guys want me? I think, so.
I'm going to ignore the fact that
third
the
floor.
Sword told her what to do. I'm, because you know what? Fuck it. I've gone through some interesting times in my life. I've seen some shit.
I've turned into a pot of plant.
Like, bandit.
Third floor. How far up were we saying that is? Because I can just teleport.
30 feet.
I can just teleport straight up to that window.
Can I just, like, pole vault with Smalls up to the third floor?
I can just teleport straight up to the window. I can teleport up to 60 feet in darkness.
Is
the window open?
Yeah.
I can hold on to, like, the ledge on top of the window or something and open it myself.
You said you can't open windows.
I mean, I have... What would that be? It would be,
The window's open.
The window's open, so I'll just teleport
open!
I'll sneak down...
The window's open.
Well, how would I get the front door open?
Well, I'll just teleport in there and toss down a rope.
Let's do that.
I give you my rope.
Call me! He'll fly you up there.
Hmm. Isn't that, like, an attorney?
1-800-GOLLY.
If I fall, I know who I'm calling.
This is also
brought to you by.
Yeah, brought to you by Sam Bernstein and Attorney Associates. But not the blind one, because he creeps me out in his commercials.
No.
That's
what
you
mean.
You think you can face him the right way.
Oh,
come on.
Yeah.
I don't know which eye to
look
at.
A lot of times I have the whole family looking at the camera, and he's just like,
You guys ever listen to Mitch Hedberg? Something exciting's happening right over there. Everyone else is paying attention this way. So let's do that. I will go ahead and use my monk powers.
Okay. Everybody make a stealth check as you go.
Also, before we do that, pass without a trace.
Do we get plus 10?
Plus 10.
37.
I'm still busy being sad about Mitch Hedberg. 30.
Come on.
Oh.
You,
you can't be sad right now. Because
you're getting drilled.
Damn.
My character's being drilled out of...
What kind of armor are you wearing?
That's a good question.
Chainmail. Oh, you don't have plate. Okay. That's what I'm using. Because plate is disadvantage.
I forgot
unless
about
it's
that.
Mine, made out of anime.
I do.
30 on my stealth check.
So that's 17 still.
Okay.
37, so...
Is that with the plus 10?
Yeah. Because I had to roll a disadvantage.
What's your dex? Is your dex...
My dex is plus 1.
Plus 1. Oh, you're saying plus 6. Okay. Never mind. Okay, so, Carrie, Rotan, you're knocked out, right? Well, you're passed out? Okay, rock on. Okay, so you guys
I'm
are
disappointed.
Able to...
No more masks.
You guys are able to make it onto the compound stealthily. You get to the back of it.
Dun, 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 dun,
and I do some cool ninja thing and a slight gust of wind happens around me and I teleport up to the window.
Okay.
I'm so glad
that
you brought
that. So I'm up there and I throw down my...
It just happens, right? That's not...
Yeah, I just teleport between darkness. Right there. Oh, yeah. I throw down my 50 feet of rope. And is there anything around me that I can adhere it to, like a pillar, column, within 20 feet?
The room you get into is a very basic, looks like a little study. I mean, there's
is there like a heavy
desks.
Desk you could tie it to?
Yeah. A heavy desk you could probably
tie it
to.
But the desk starts...
Is it carpeted?
You know what? Then... Oh, I can't.
They try not to have too much fabric, considering the flames that flicker around the place too much.
I kind of want to try to see if I can just make the climb.
You want to climb up the rope? I'll hold on to the rope.
Yeah, because I'm not that heavy.
Yeah.
Climbing is in athletics.
Nat 20.
Yeah, you're fine.
So 24.
No,
you
don't need
even,
the rope.
I just parkour it.
You hold it
with
one hand.
I'm going to do that too.
It's extra.
Nat 20. What the fuck? Okay.
Yeah, I suppose I'll try.
Little did you know,
five altogether.
Is that your magic number?
But what
no.
is it? What is it?
No, it's a 3.
Okay, I thought that was a 1.
No.
Okay.
Oh,
no,
it's just a
5.
It's just
a
bad roll.
I thought it was a 1 too.
I was hoping it was a 1
Devil
just because
like,
of that.
Like, you literally like take Smalls and you like jab it into the wall, and then you like hop up, and as you hop up, you pull Smalls out of the wall again, and that's like how you're climbing up. Valdo's just straight up parkour, is it?
I'm like the fat kid in gym class. I gotta go to grab the rope, and I just slide down.
Yeah,
the rope wasn't actually connected to anything, and she just falls into the.
That's what happened. Yeah, Bruce didn't connect the rope to anything yet, and you just tried.
No, I was holding it. I was holding it. Now Balthus up there, so he can help me hold it. She's up there, so she can help me hold it.
And you all can look down and watch her fail.
Also,
I'll just stay here, guys. I'll keep watch.
22 to perception to see if
that
I can
actually
hear...
might be wise, considering you have disadvantage to all of your stealth checks.
Probably is a good idea,
yeah,
actually. I'll just stay here.
Okay. 27 perceptions to see here if I can hear light thumping or panting, perhaps, to know where to avoid.
You hear
screams,
all of
probably.
Those things in the room directly to, like, right outside the door, and then just right.
Okay.
So go on.
There's also smoke, like, coming out. Well, the room that you're in is at the very end of the hallway. You're going to be going, like, straight down a hallway, and the other opposite end of a hallway is a iron spiral staircase with, like, in all of the slates of the iron is, like flame designs.
Passive perception of 16. If I can, before we start walking down there, just to see if I see any guards or anything in this house, I'm not too sure. No? So I kind of will motion to everybody quietly to walk down the metal staircase. You said it's metal, right?
Mm-hmm. It's okay. Going up.
It's going up. We need to go to the attic. What's up?
It's going to be tink, tink, tink.
Well, we have pass without a trace on. I can't.
You guys are going to make another stealth check as you walk past the door.
While I'm standing out there, I'm going to make a perception check to
you're
see.
You're also going to make a con save, Leah. That's 15
plus 7.
Okay. I'm going to make a perception check just to make sure I don't see anybody, like,
oh, 32.
Wandering around.
22. Don't forget, plus 10.
I got
really
burning.
16.
Oh, 16, okay.
9 to see if anyone's, like, watching.
It's not like 13. It's not like it's going to do too much to you, though.
Okay.
It's cute.
You see Rotem walking down the road.
He goes in the wrong one.
Mm.
Plus 12 damage. Piercing.
Piercing.
Oh,
Jenna's just not having it. She's just like, oh my god.
Nope, just
nope.
I'm turning your shit.
Well,
double
you have to
ponder. Double entendre.
Well, considering.
Cry, you little
one. Because you're crying. Oh my god. Oh man.
We're stealthing. And we're moving along.
Wait, I was about to say, did I actually take damage?
Yeah,
you didn't say how much.
You took
it was the 12.
It was the 12? Okay,
yeah.
So 6.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the lowest stealth score we had was a 16.
Was that on your second, your roll for going down the hallway?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, you're good.
All right, so we are going up the spiral staircase to the attic. Passive perception of 16 just to see if I can see anything before we kind of, you know, the floor is probably like a pier. We're going around, I'm like peeking my head out a little bit.
Roll one last stealth for peeking your head up.
That works.
31.
They definitely don't see you.
They don't.
But you see, creeping around in the attic, it kind of like pops up and like walking around next to this like giant, like really intense granite looking with like a bunch of runes carved into it, vault. Literally, like, vault, like a safe vault.
Yeah.
You see, walking around... I see three of these.
There's a puppy.
What is this shit?
It's that thing.
He sees black blobs. Because...
Look, I can read upside down. I know everything now.
I actually can't read upside down. I'm backwards.
Okay,
So, actually, we should probably leave there.
Yeah.
I don't feel like getting up a mat, so we're not gonna do that.
We're gonna be like over here.
I'm just straight up to laser.
Not in battle, still taking damage. Whatever.
You're outside.
Yeah, I'm outside. She's down the hall. Yeah.
He's drunk at the bar, passed out.
So we got these three little doors. And then we'll say the vault is like right here. They're just kind of all pacing around. And then, yeah, the staircase would be right there.
So, it's weird that you can't up and down on this camera, so.
Well,
the
there's
Qdoba.
All the, yeah, the Qdoba is what's in the way.
And the rules.
I meant, like, I can move my screen up and down, like, it
oh.
would move up and down.
Well, can you?
So I wanna duck my head back really quick and tell who's closest to me, Baldos. And if, you're in earshot too. I see three puppies. I'm gonna go play with them.
I'll give them a milk bone.
What was that?
Can you
rotate
me to the left?
Just
a
smidge. Lewis is cornered by the dog. Hey, pup, I think I got a milk bone. And he gets mangled by it and dies.
I'm just thinking of bacon strips.
Bacon!
I really need to go see it.
I'd say do this too, masseuse. The chiropractor's kind of nice, but it feels much better if you just
take poison potion and some pieces of meat. And combine them.
Oh, wow.
What are you doing?
Poison potion, pieces of meat, combine them.
That's a low.
Okay.
Low.
Well, this potion is about as bad as the rest of us, so he probably could use some spine work.
Actually, it really doesn't take anything to do that. So you, the meat.
Should I do it?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and...
We're totally killing these people's random pet animals.
Take these pieces of poison meat, essentially,
anyway,
and toss them into a corner.
Okay. Do a dex or like a range attack.
Range attack.
There'll be a dex to toss it.
Oh, 7, 12, or I'm sorry, 11, essentially.
Okay, so, and that'll get it across the room into a corner. It does make a noise when it thuds a little bit, though, but you guys all kind of freeze for a minute. Like, hold your breath, and then you just hear the thudding and, like, a sparkle of fire again.
Oh, man.
And that's about all that happens. The hellhounds kind of immediately, like, zip up and look around, and then they, like, kind of all dart to the corner with the meat.
Hmm. Perception check to see if they're eating it?
They're eating it.
They are eating it.
I mean, I was going to slip some roofies in it, but that'll work, too.
Of course you could have done that. Just slip a bunch of weed in there.
Don't waste your roofies or your weed.
So, I have the mold,
you
right?
You have a bunch
of
roofies,
key.
Too?
Okay.
Obviously.
Can I see what the lock looks like from here? I believe I have dark vision.
You don't see a lock. You see a collection of rooms, and in the very center, like, they all kind of spiral around to a central point. Similar to what you would have saw on the door if you had seen
the door. What was that?
You should have took my keyblade. It opens any lock.
Sure. So what I'm thinking is I'll tell
people. Well, too bad you passed out. I forgot about that.
With my tinder in one hand and the key
I'm about
in the
passed
other
out.
One.
Yeah, you're right.
Teleport over there once I get over there and light it. The dogs are going to be aware, though.
Wait. Is that the actual vault door? Is that the door before the vault
that's
door?
That's a good question.
Because remember, we can only use it on the vault door. And I think there was actually... on a different stage.
Are we in the actual attic now?
Yeah.
Well,
is there actually... I have a very important question for you guys. It's totally off topic, but, is there a necromancer class in this game?
Yeah, it's wizard.
Is there a wizard?
Yeah.
You have to do a wizard and then, like,
be
very specific with your spell choices.
So I can cast silence on us. Make
I think
this
Claire
entire fight.
Too.
Make player. The entire fight with the dogs completely silent. But anything within 15 feet, no spells can be used.
I can sleep them if they're still alive after you poison them.
Do you have anything you can do?
What
she can throw smalls
can you do
at them.
Anything?
Like,
hold on,
that'll
guys,
be
hold on.
Nice.
Maybe like calm animal or something, if anyone has that. Or like...
I don't
even know. What?
I have animal handling.
Oh, yeah, I know you're handling some kind of animal
right now. Actually, more of a snake. They're starting to, like, their bodies are kind of starting to, like, this is like they're hungry, so they're chowing.
So, what do you guys want to do? Well, Amy.
Did you say he can see with the key? Looks like, or the... It's a spiral of rooms leading to a central point.
Does that seem like the... I explained the design to you. Does that seem like the door, the vault door?
Smalls. Can I ask Smalls?
Mm-hmm.
What do you want me to roll?
Like a boss.
Is it a bad that I'm making a character for our next adventure?
All right.
Yeah. What up, man?
I'm making my character for my next adventure now.
Well, it's not like you can do anything else since you're passed out.
We'll be back for you very soon. So, all right, I'm getting the go-ahead. So in a small gust of wind, I just teleport in front of the door with Tinder in one hand and the lock in the other, and I pull it, or the key, I put it up against the central room and light it.
You hold the fire to it and it does nothing. That was not how Blinks told you to use it.
Damn, what did she say?
I was banging her cousin, so I have no idea what she was saying.
I don't remember.
Smalls.
Do you remember?
Mm.
That's great. I was banging her cousin. I don't remember.
I don't remember. I'm not even there to tell you, but I actually don't remember.
I think he crashed.
I don't know.
No!
Wait.
That's good.
No, my computer's doing a virus search.
When I first glanced up, I didn't realize Skype had gone down, and I'm like, whoa, Chris is really close to the camera.
Chris is beautiful.
Oh, man, Chris is looking lovely today.
You're good. Sorry. My computer was trying to do a virus scan.
Well,
Okay, I'm going to roll.
I'll just teleport back then.
Hang on, I'm going to roll to see if I remember this. Would that be a history, I guess?
Yeah, history or probably
she
insight
says just
or something.
Light it up.
History would be 14.
I got a nat 20 on my history roll to see if I can remember what she said, what you said, because I don't.
She told you that it was concentrated flame from somebody of her family's bloodline that she created, encased in clay.
I gotta crack it then.
Small said, throw it.
Okay.
Yeah, like just like throw it against the door.
I do that.
Are you standing right next to it?
I was gonna say deck save because you're standing right next to the door as the flames go off.
Oh, did you teleport back?
Nope.
Bat 20.
Oh.
He's
you don't roll the away.
I like to
he throws it as each other rolls.
Flames as
this is the exact opposite of last week. We're all rolling really high.
Yeah.
Did you remember my first two rolls here?
Yeah, it was rolling.
Yeah, but remember me last week? I had, what, 6 in a row that was magic number and crit fail? I was pulling you last week.
Yeah.
Bad.
Yeah, man.
Okay, so similar to what you guys happened on the door when Trent laid his hand on it and, like, kind of pushed flames through it, the runes all glow, little licks of flame bust through them as the kind of casing explodes on it. The vault kind of swirls all of the granite runes and stuff kind of, like, twist around and, like, swirl open into, like, a round opening. And inside, you guys are kind of hit with this like, kind of rush of arcane energy. Nothing damaging, just you sense. You feel it. Even right. Those of you not attuned.
Well, the vault's open.
Let's go. How are the dogs doing? Perception? 10. Plus, 2. 12.
They're finishing their snacks. I'm assuming that you are stealthed and have moved away from the door.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
You guys are both still hiding in the staircase. The dogs have kind of jumped up. What are you doing right now? The dogs kind of are like, they finish their food and they're turning around at the sound of the vault opening.
And the vault's just a wide open room?
Well, it's an opening into a wide open room.
What's the room we're standing in look like? Does it have pillars or anything? Mm-hmm. Well, I will go ahead and hide behind a pillar then.
Okay. The dogs kind of sniff around. One of them kind of makes its way over. Two of them are kind of heading towards the staircase by you guys, and one of them makes its way towards the pillar that you have jumped up and hid behind. It's kind of sniffing at the base of it, and it's kind of creeping around towards where you're at.
Oh my god.
I teleport behind the other pillar.
Okay. Make a stealth on your teleport.
What is that? 15?
Lot. you make it fine, and then the dog kind of stops and like, looks around confused and kind of sniffs at the air. And kind of shrugs.
Can
and then
the book?
Sees that the
sure.
other two dogs are like kind of looking towards something and kind of like whining a little bit to themselves and they're going towards the staircase.
Hold on one second.
Is the vault 30 feet of where I'm standing?
Okay.
I'm going to use Misty Step to go into the vault then.
Okay.
Hang on, I'm checking something.
Oh, I don't have to do anything. So it's just a bonus action.
Yep, it happens. You guys are also not in combat right now, so you can pretty much just use whatever. Okay, yeah, you Misty Step into, I'm going to say that's going to get you right inside of the vault. What are you going to do as soon as you get there?
I want to check the traps.
That's so smart, because I would have been like, run! Run through it!
Yeah, that's an investigation.
Ooh, that's good. That's just 9.
None that you see, you're pretty sure that the hellhounds are the trap and the lock. They're very uppity and
haunchy
and sure of themselves.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and, while she's doing that, teleport next to her.
How many times can you use that?
It's my movement now.
Is
at 6th level, when you gain the ability to step from one shadow to another, when you're in dim light or darkness, as a bonus action, you can teleport up to 60 feet to an unoccupied space.
So those are not in combat.
Yeah, and it is dim light because you only have, flickering light right now. It's not magic, so. Okay, cool. So you guys are both in battles. What are you doing? You got 3 hellhounds coming towards you.
I'm actually trying to figure out how I can get out of this without making too much noise.
Very quickly they're coming towards you. Like, they're creeping, but they're getting close.
Why don't you try to sleep?
I do have sleep. Okay, so I'm going to take a giant puff of my leaf, and I'm gonna cast.
I'm gonna cast night night.
Oh, I'm gonna blow it in that. I'm gonna give a good blow in that direction.
Oh my goodness.
And I'm going to cast sleep.
Okay. Shouldn't be that hard.
I feel like I can't watch.
Can
you see what sleep is real quick? My phone.
What level are you casting it at?
Yeah, that's a good question. Because
it's like 8d8.
It's at like level 2.
I think it's like 10d8 then.
Let me pull up the spell book. I think it's just sleep.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see. At what spell you said?
Level 2.
Level 2. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So just watch our all ones.
Hey,
I did that
so
one.
So it's. Wow, it's 7d8.
Yeah.
For level 2?
Yeah.
Oh, is it 6 and then 1d8 every level up?
It
starts
at
5
and then 2d8.
Oh,
yep.
Oh, excuse me.
6. 7. Alright.
Sleep is one of my faves. I love it.
So I'm going to euthanize these dogs.
I like the poison to that.
Yeah.
So.
8,
one,
10, 20. 5, 26.
Okay. Two of them definitely fall asleep.
Okay.
The third one kind of looks a little bit groggy, looks over and sees his friends asleep, and then looks down, like he's kind of like getting a little bit frantic, and he's just kind of like jumping around the room trying to figure out what's going on. He's clearly noticed something is wrong.
I use Thermogy to cast a sound in a corner away from everyone else.
Okay.
Of a rat.
He follows it.
And I stealthily go into the room. With a 9. Well, wait, plus, am I close enough to him? How far away is Bruce from me?
About 30 feet right now.
Oh, so it's a 19.
Okay, that'll be able to help you make it. Yeah, so you guys are all in the vault.
I had to put two of them to sleep.
You have two hellhounds asleep, one of them following the sound of a rat in the corner. It will notice that it's not a rat at some point, so.
I'm looking for a windowsill.
Okay.
To kick it out of?
What would that be?
Or was that just makes me think of hellhound puppies.
I use my mind.
Well, I don't see one. I rolled an 8.
Well, you see that there's windowsills. There's two on each side of the room.
Okay.
So there's like three sides of the room, and there's two on each side. So there's six of them all together.
So we should each take a windowsill, because it's supposed to be in a windowsill.
Okay.
Because a necromantic skeleton sounds like an amazing plan.
A necromantic what?
Skeleton.
I have a mini for that.
You do, yeah.
That would be amazing.
I feel like necromancers don't get super cool until they can start raising dead at like level 7. Though.
Yeah, no, you have to do a custom necromancer to make it not suck.
I'll invest in necromancy. If I'm gonna do a skeleton necromancer, I'm gonna be freaking like Skeletor from He-Man.
Fuck yes.
I have the mini for that actually.
That gets fucker.
Really?
Yeah.
I gotta make it now.
You got it. All right. So what are you guys doing?
We'll each take a windowsill.
Okay, there's six of them, so...
Well, each side, right?
A side
you
of the
said
room.
Three sides, so each person takes a side of the room.
Okay, so who's going left, who's going right, and who's going to the far side?
I'll go to the far side since I can teleport.
Okay.
I'll go left.
And I'll go to the other one.
Okay. Since you're teleporting, you're fine. Both of you guys make dexterity checks to make sure that you don't trip over shiny and clinky things.
21.
21.
4.
As Gil's walking, he accidentally kicks a set of brass enchanted armor, and a plume of flame juts out of it, and makes noise.
What kind of flame?
Green flame!
I use thermogy to shut the door behind us. Wait, should I do that?
I mean, there's windows. Thermogy
energy is not going to work on that vault door.
It shuts the door, it doesn't open it. I mean,
it's not a door, it's a vault.
So,
stone, magical, arcane vault.
Okay, never mind.
I just
work on it.
Kind of shoot a glare and just say,
you kind of hear a whine from the door outside.
I immediately check one of my windowsills. I will choose odds and evens, left, right. And it is an even. I'll choose the right windowsill.
Did you choose the right one?
Did not, unfortunately.
Let me make it. Alright,
none there?
I'm checking the left one with the 20, so.
Yeah, it was actually on your windowsill, which is ironic.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. So you found it?
Yeah, I guess I found it.
You're looking for it.
The relic.
The relic.
Do you know what it looks like?
It's a stoon.
Stoon.
It's a stoon.
There's a couple pretty stoons. Stoon in the window.
Take them all.
Grab and go.
Yeah.
Can I go over to his windowsill?
Stones.
And see if I recognize it?
No dexterity check.
I'll check.
There we go. 17.
Okay. Wait, isn't that your magic number?
I want to check.
It
my
is. Yeah,
it is, but I rolled a 15.
Oh, okay.
Wow, we actually sound
okay,
kind of disappointed.
The whining has turned into growling. You do make it over to the windowsill, though.
Okay.
However, you guys literally have, like, 10 seconds.
Do I see a ruby with orange vein cracks in it?
You do.
I grab it.
Okay.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Cast darkness on the dogs.
Cast darkness. I don't know if they can smell.
Darkness. Imprisonment.
They're not magical dark vision, though.
They're hellhounds.
They can't see through darkness. Unless they have true sight, right?
Yeah, magical darkness. Dark vision doesn't do anything with magical darkness.
Can we just go out the window?
Yeah,
just go out the window.
Advantage on checks for hearing and smell, though.
Okay, well, I mean, I'm fine jumping out the window because I got slow fall. So
I do too.
I do not.
They're closed windows, so what are you guys doing?
You ready?
Smash them one?
Open the window? They're closed and locked arcanely, because this is a magic vault, so what are you doing?
Smashing one?
Can we just run through it?
I'll turn around. I guess I'll just fight the dogs, you guys run, or we can just kill these things.
These things gotta be pretty messed up, man. You poison the shit out of them.
Yeah.
They're gonna
other people out.
Yeah, they're
I'll cast silence on them and myself. I'll fight them or keep them distracted. You guys bolt.
Okay, if that's what you want to do.
Okay, so as my bonus action, I essentially, I'll distract the dogs. I'll teleport right in the middle of all of them.
Okay. Well, two of them are asleep. There's only one that's awake.
Oh, there's only one that's awake.
I inspire you
okay.
for your greatness.
Awesome. So I will go ahead and cast silence on the one dog, and as my bonus action, teleport straight to him. And begin the mutilation.
All right, we're running.
Yeah.
All right, you guys are able to get down the stairs as he's fighting. It's starting to make noise, so you start running a little bit faster.
Who, me?
Yeah.
No silence appears within 15 feet of the dog at all, because I cast silence on him.
So
no noises.
Okay, rock and roll then.
Yes,
so
this
what you're going to do with the dog then.
What I'm going to do with the dog...
Stuff that's only legal in southern states.
Is... So I'm
that's
down
why we
to
need the silence.
Oh, damn.
Since I teleported, my first melee attack gets advantage. I also get... This is going to get ridiculous now.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Okay, so advantage on my... the power I gained from my mother, called the Fist of Unbroken Air.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
16. 3. So, essentially...
So 16.
Well, what would that be? 16, 17, 18.
23.
You
hit.
23 to hit.
Yep.
Okay, and then it's a 3d10 damage, and I'll go ahead and add 2d10s to it.
There's the 2d10s.
And my sneak attack as well.
That thing is...
3d10s, or 3, or did I say 3? No.
So 3d10s, and you rolled a d8.
I was
saying... My bad. You guys have to forgive me here. First time
Do you want? I have a bunch of D10s in this
it's
bin right here.
3D10 plus 2, so 5D10 essentially.
Here.
I don't know if I need that much, but whatever.
Wait, what do you mean 3D10? It's 3D10, so if you roll like 30, it's plus 2, it's 32.
It's 3D10, but then I can spend an extra ki point to put an extra D10 in there. So I have 4 ki points, so I used
What's
2, 3. I don't know, man. And, actually.
It sounded cool.
Well, yeah.
So
it's cool. But
5,
not for...
14... 17, right, 14, yeah, 17, 18, and then I get one more.
Oh, come on. 22.
23.
Plus my sneak attack, which is 2d6.
Sorry, that's 23. 6. 5.
So that's an extra 11 on top of 23, so 33 damage.
34.
34
damage.
Next time you guys have, like, a big amount to roll, just tell me now. Put it in the
center.
Because I can just put how many... numbers the die.
But that's not as fun.
Yeah, it's not as fun for us.
So how would you like to do this?
Alright, so
because I'll think something dead.
So the entire action went, I basically cast silence on it, all of a sudden a dead silence spreads across the room, and a slight gust of wind appears around me as I teleport right in front of the dog. And before the dog can even react, all the gold emblems, or all the gold wind sewn into my robes, slightly glow a little bit as I just push one fist forward, and it's like just swirls of energy, just swirls of wind that just rip apart this animal.
Okay.
So basically you went straight to the shoulder.
This is what's going down. The beast is very concerned and terrified that its pack is asleep. They're all like starting to feel really gross and groggy from your poison that you did. So this is totally what happened. You are in the vault, you tell Balathos and Gibble to just run, and as they start running, as soon as you see the beast kind of turn its head in their slight direction, you immediately are just like, and there's like a shimmer in the air around it of just utter, like, perfect deafening silence in the sound barrier around him. And then you start dashing forward, and then like this like burst of shadow, like you kind of like pull your fist back and start pushing it forward, and then all of a sudden you're engulfed in shadows. And then all of a sudden the shadows reappear right in front of it, and you just uppercut with this gust of air that just tears through it. And it actually, like, cuts into some of its fur and just shatters its jaw.
You just
awesome.
Akuma'd the shit out of it.
Awesome.
I just realized that.
I dig it. And before the dog can even hit the floor, I just teleport straight behind you guys. Just join up.
Bro, you straight raging demon.
I'm exhausted, though. There's all my Kai points. We're done.
That's what we want to point anything
I'm
else.
Speaking of exhaustion, how are you doing?
That's a good question. How am I doing?
How are you doing?
That one. Oh my gosh! Just
magic
going off
in
the bedroom.
Isn't that a D12?
No,
it's a
D20.
Why does it look so different?
I don't know.
I think it's the color.
So there's more than one form of magic going on in this room right now. Let's see the percentiles.
Oh gosh, this is gonna be great.
If it's a 1 or 100, she's pregnant. That's it.
75.
Okay.
Oh.
So she's only 3/4 pregnant.
3/4 pregnant.
You suddenly glow in a bright supernatural light.
I think she was doing that already.
It kind of creates like this just utterly shining, bright, blinding light emanating from your body at just the right moment. And all of a sudden, Trent is just like, oh my god, what the fuck? And you're just like, shut the fuck up, bitch. And just put a shim back down in the bed, and you're just like, shut your eyes. Just shut your eyes. Just don't worry about it. As you guys dart
past... They're so close!
As you guys dart past the door, it's just like, there's just this bright as fuck light coming out from underneath, and it's just like spreading across the granite floor.
And I take a look, and I hear what's going on, and I'm like, so that's what it's like.
So
you're doing it wrong.
From.
You're doing it wrong.
Dude, I told you that was real. I told you it wasn't a myth. I've seen that before.
Wait, what?
Okay, so
my character randomly saw some real raunchy stuff, like real
just
raunchy.
Really bad
last
stuff.
Week, like
raunchy
on
yeah,
he walked in.
Oh yeah,
real
yeah.
raunchy.
Yeah, his character walked in on my character kind of giving the business very viciously to someone.
Is that supposed to be like that?
there was no love in that situation.
Okay, so you guys get out to the window. How are you getting down?
Stealth
check.
Oh, my concentration's broken, you guys.
12.
I don't have anything to recast it either. My concentration's broken.
All right.
For stealth, I got a 19.
It's a
12.
You won't forget.
Okay, you two are okay. However, Gibble is dragging his sword behind him, because he's just trying to, like, bust the fuck out, and he's, like, holding the gem, he's like, it's pretty, and just, like, dragging his sword, and it's making, like, against the granite, it's just, like, as he's dragging it. Trenton hears it, and he just kind of sits up, like, with his eyes still closed, and he's just like, what was that?
This is your chance to shine.
Yes.
I think she was already shining.
She's...
Wait,
that's so appropriate for your character.
Gibble's dragging his sword along with him behind him, and it's like making a really loud squeaking noise against the granite floor, and Trenton has kind of set up and he's just like, what was that?
Oh. Wow.
That's right.
Well, I don't want to... Let's see.
You know.
And you don't know that it's them.
I don't know it's them.
No. Cannot meta this.
Oh, man.
Quick, say it's Quaid.
What?
Whoa.
I hear the sound of sheet metal tearing. Whoa.
No.
It was just some air. It was just some trapped air.
No.
You could have passed that off.
I'm just gonna close his back up before I spill this on accident.
He's crying.
Oh my gosh, he's bright red too. Probably from holding his breath while trying to laugh.
There was a weird pocket of air in there.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, this is so much better than doing another call.
Well, my character has no clue, so she'd probably wonder what it is too.
Okay. So what, you guys just gonna go free balling out the check, or you gonna put out a
over something? I'll free ball out the check.
Right on.
I'll probably grab my sword on the way.
Okay. You guys have made it to
the window. Don't worry about pants. You want some, right?
What are you saying, Christian?
Hey, what's a good place to get a notable character sheets from?
I just Google.
Yeah.
Reddit?
Yeah, Google fillable character sheets Reddit, because that's literally anytime I need to have a question answered or opinion, I type in the question and then put Reddit afterwards, and I trust that more than anything.
No, that's where we got these.
Yeah.
Ooh,
so
nice.
We made it to the window.
Have you seen this yet?
You guys have made it to the window. However, you hear shuffling in the room.
Oh yeah, I've seen so
behind you, and you hear the door open.
Okay.
Wait.
Thermogy to close the door.
Am I looking at first?
The door slams shut in front of you and Trenton.
No, put it back there.
I tell you guys to go, and I'll hold the rope.
He immediately is concerned, and his hand lights up as he grabs the doorknob and melts it and shoves the door open.
Actually, if he melted the doorknob, wouldn't that just, singe it together? He'd have to break it down at that
point.
Well,
he does something to have the door open.
He's magic.
The scientist nodded in agreement with me on that.
Not an evil door.
The metal worker knows how melting metals work. Wait, you guys are actually talking to each other? Can I hear anything?
No, they've been stealthing this entire time. All you heard was the squeak against the floor.
Man, good job.
So, I didn't say slam, I said close it, but we'll go slam. That's funny.
So you have
slow. Well, either way, they opened it and it closed at them. So
I'll hold the rope while she goes down it, because I don't think you want to jump from the third story.
I'm jumping straight out the window with
her.
So I'm jumping, grabbing my coat,
Hell, if he's going forward, I let him go first, man.
I'll do what I said.
Okay.
I'll hold the rope while you climb down.
He's going to hold the rope while I climb down.
Okay.
What is that? Is that going to be
athletics?
Should be 17. Okay. Your athletics was 7?
Yeah.
Damn.
So.
Okay. So, Gibble gets down the rope just fine. However, Trenton. Wow. So, Trenton looks right first. You're left. What do you do?
Right first, my left.
He looks right first. You're left.
He walks out the door and looks right.
He sees
you.
Left.
Oh,
he
didn't see you yet.
She made it down to the floor. I hold one end of the rope and teleport down to the floor.
Wow.
Ninja vanish.
I rolled a 2.
Oh.
That's good. I would have said something real smart. It wouldn't have been fun.
It would have been funny.
Okay, so that happened, and that you guys actually did that without
botching it.
Woo!
So. And roll that happened.
I noticed that you guys.
I guess
like,
if we saw
nothing,
we were just going
into what the fuck happened.
We ran into
like,
oh god, I don't believe you're running. we'll go with that. Drag him back.
And he goes
save.
Yep.
He goes
gonna,
ever so willingly.
You gonna get an Uber and meet us eventually, or what?
Oh, that hurt.
What?
So,
my character must have more stamina than his or something.
So
I
don't
know. No, I just
can
control it when I want.
Take the group back to wherever Christian's passed out.
Mine doesn't do it as often.
Ah, that was the bar.
Alright, so we're gonna pick up Christian. Hopefully talk to... Well, this is what I want to do. Pick up Christian, hopefully talk to Blinks, let her know what's happening. Rest. Play... Freaking
I'm sure
dumb if Trent comes around.
Obviously.
And get you back. Come on.
So I'm probably already at the shop.
Can't even walk at this point.
I think you're still passed out. We're still trying to find you.
This is night. You're at the tavern. When you get to the tavern, you talk to the bartender, and you're just like, "Hey, yo, where's Blinks and Rotan?" And tell you that she took him back to his shop because he was like passed out and they were closing down. You like catch the bartender as he's walking out the door.
All right, so I'm back to the shop.
Yep.
Okay, you get there. Blinks, you kind of knock a few times. Blinks lets you in. She says that you're welcome to, you know, chill in the back for the night. She, you know, she's got enough, you know, cots and stuff laid about from where she kind of crashes whenever she's working on something.
All right, long rest.
You casually see a cloaked, very scary-looking woman playing with a rat in the back corner, but you don't question it.
Yeah, don't question it.
She kind of glares at you once.
It's a halfling.
It's a halfling with a very scary cloak and dual crossbows and a pet mouse that she's feeding. She glares at you once, and you just kind of shiver and look away, and you just decide not to question it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have the weirdest boner right now.
Of course you do. Are you gonna go snuff?
That technically would have been a 28, but no,
no.
I just want to see what I draw.
The character is now pregnant.
No. hey,
that's Jen's character this time.
No.
Do you really want to give us a ready? You know how cold she is.
I'm not asking for a loving fuck. I'm just asking for a fuck.
Do you have one to give?
Your character, you can jump and RP your character if you want to roll this out.
No.
I was just going to let
just
this just
no.
slide
just
through.
No.
In other words.
It's Jen's character. I'm going to let her do her character.
You just feel the waves of hatred coming off her. You know not to even go close.
I go reach my pocket. Like, do I remember where the address of that one chick I was just with? Yeah, okay, I'll go to that.
All right, cool. So you guys are chilling for the night, I assume?
Yeah. Heal up.
You're firing.
I'm eventually sleeping so I can have a long rest.
Yeah. Are you sleeping
Quitter.
There?
Yeah.
Quitter.
Okay. Right on.
Good.
So no, Trent eventually passes out next to her.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, rolls over and falls asleep. Cool. So
yeah.
You guys taking a long rest? Okay.
We take a long rest. We wait until the morning.
Gain your spells and such back. Heal up if you took damage. You wake up. And,
just giggling at the damage.
Damage.
You guys wake up and you smell a very odd scent, like lingering around through the shop.
Is it? Is it Balathos or is it Maxa?
What are you doing? It's morning. Are you gonna?
That would have been 8.
One more round, man. Come on.
Oh, damn. Okay. Con save.
Yes.
No.
Because he woke up with
14.
He woke up with morning flame dick.
14.
And that's not enough. So
I'm sure there's more than just friction burn down there now. So I rolled an 18 for perception.
Wow. So I was going to roll 4d4 for that, and I only got 10.
So still 5.
Because of all.